Hi everyone, Nick here. I wanted to come over with a really quick tip here when you're working with icons in PowerPoint. So I use icons all the time in PowerPoint, and oftentimes I'm putting them inside of circles. So this is just an example right here. These are two shapes. So this is the icon right here. This is the circle. And I just put one on top of the other, and I work with the alignment tools in PowerPoint to make sure that everything is exactly centered. Now, both of these are circles with a play button or a triangle icon in the middle, and both of them are exactly centered and exactly middle. So centered and middled to the circle behind it. But if you look closely, you will see that they are not actually aligned. So if they were both the same and both centered, then this baseline here on the triangle should align with the dotted line. But you can see the one on the bottom is actually, that triangle goes a little bit over that line. It overlaps. It's not actually centered in that circle. And I'm going to show you what I mean. Now, I got this tip over from Smash Magazine, Laurent Baumann, Practical Design Tips and Guidelines for Beginning Designers. This is an awesome blog post, and I'll link to it below. I learned a lot of really interesting tips, including this tip with the icons. Now, the way that we need to do this, I'm going to go over here and I'm going to show you what happens. So here's just my circle. I inserted this from PowerPoint. Let's go ahead and insert the play button. Now, this will be relevant to any icon that is sort of in the similar fashion to this play button. Let's just see if play will pop up. And then we have, yes, right here, we have that triangle. I'm going to go ahead and turn it white. And now I'm going to put it inside of my circle. Now I'm going to go ahead like this. Now what normally I would do, you can see that the icon comes up. It's this perfectly square border right here. I would normally hold down shift, select both of them. And then I'm going to go to the alignment tools. We're going to center and we are going to align middle. Now everything is beautiful and centered aligned, but the actual icon doesn't look aligned to that circle. So what I would then normally do maybe is just push the right arrow key over until it kind of visually looks okay, centered and aligned. I'm gonna go ahead and undo all of those. But there is a way to do this in PowerPoint so that it's exactly centered. So I'm gonna go ahead and control copy. We're gonna go ahead and paste these over to the side. And I'm going to show you how we do this. Now, you have to, in order to make it exactly centered, you have to crop this image to a circle so that the circle is touching each of the bound or each of the corners on the image. So what I do here is with the icon selected, we're going to go to Graphics Format tab and then click on Crop. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to crop this to a circle and then make sure that it's still, the aspect ratio is 1:1. Now you can see the circle and you can see that it's cropped. It's already touching two of the corners of the triangle, but this one is not. So I'm going to go ahead and drag this over like this so that it's touching all of the corners, and then maybe I have to adjust it just a little bit so that those corners are touching. Now I'm going to go ahead and click on crop. So now it's actually a circle here, and now I'm going to hold down shift, select both of them, and then with the alignment tools here, we're going to say center and middle. Perfect. Now you see that we have a perfectly centered triangle there in the middle of the circle, and that is different than this one. So sometimes when you have an icon, you just have to be aware of that, and you have to make sure that if you have an icon where this isn't exactly centered and aligned like this, you can actually center it by cropping this to a circle, making sure that that circle is touching each of the points, and then center and aligning it just like this. So perfect alignment for icons in circles. So thank you again, Laurent, over here on Smash Magazine, this blog post right here, Practical Design Tips and Guidelines for Beginner Designers. I'll put that in the comments below. I hope you go and check it out. I'm definitely going to check that out. And also, I want to put the link here. I actually have a running Google Doc of design information and data design resources. And this is just really a hodgepodge list of all of the different websites, blog posts, anything that's helpful that I find online through my scrolling of LinkedIn or Twitter or other things, I just kind of put here. And it's an open Google Doc. So if you have design resources that aren't on the list, please feel free to go ahead and add those in. I'm going to add this link below as well. If you like this video, I hope you will give it a thumbs up and make sure to click the subscribe button, hit the bell next to it every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. You will get notified of that if you hit that bell next to the subscribe button. I hope you all had a great time watching this. I had a great time making it, and I'll see you all next time.